Today, I cover everything you need to know about previews in Lightroom, and knowing this can really help speed up your workflow. Whenever you import RAW files into Lightroom, the computer needs a way to see the image saved in that RAW data easily. And the quickest way to do this is through previews. In Lightroom's import window, there is a drop-down menu on the right-hand side called File Handling. In this, there are a few different options, including previews. Now, there are a few to choose from, and if you choose the wrong preview, your computer can really slow down. So it's important to know which one to select so you don't end up throwing your computer pretty much out of the window due to frustration from it being so slow. First off, the reason Lightroom has to make these previews is because it's a non-destructive editor. This means it leaves the original file alone and keeps a record of what changes you've made to the image, if any. Now, this is great as you'll always have that original file with no changes made to go back to if you mess things up in the edit. However, there are 5 different previews to choose from, so picking one is really important. Also, you might not know this, but different previews work better in different modules. Some work better in the library module, whereas others work better in the develop module. But I'll talk about that, including what I do, a little bit later on in this video. For each of the different preview types, I've tested them out, loading 10 images from my mechanical USB-C hard drive with the catalog saved on that drive as well, and then also from my internal SSD drive on my 2017 2.9 GHz quad-core i7 MacBook Pro. With the catalog saved on that SSD drive. All of the images have already been transferred to the hard drive that I'm using in each scenario, and I'm only adding them to the catalog, not using the import page to copy them to that hard drive. Now, if I've gone over your head with this already, check out my Lightroom workflow linked in the corner or in the description. I did make it a while back, so I might seem a little bit sleepy in it, but in that, I go through my backup process, my import process, and editing my images in it as well. So let's have a closer look at the different previews. Minimal previews are exactly as they're described. Lightroom will build a minimal preview from the RAW file and then give you that to see the image in the library module. On my external mechanical hard drive, it took 10 seconds to build 10 of these minimal previews. So this was an average of 1 second per image. With the internal SSD, it took 3 seconds for the set of 10 to load. So straight away, you can see the difference in speeds of the different hard drives. When using the catalog from either of the drives, it was a bit glitchy when zooming in the library module, and also when flicking through that film strip along the bottom. This was a little slow on both the hard drive and the SSD. I like to flick through the images really quickly and star rate the ones that I like. So when I go through thousands of images from a day's shoot, this can get a little bit frustrating with these previews. When I opened them up in the develop module, it did take a short while to load them up, but then the zoom feature was a lot smoother in this editing module. Embedded and sidecar previews are the ones that have been built into the RAW file by the camera. With the external mechanical hard drive, it took 5 seconds to load 10 images, and with the SSD, it took 4 seconds. So compared to those minimal previews I've just talked about, this is a lot quicker with the mechanical hard drive, but not quite as quick as with the internal SSD. They are by far the quickest way to load your images into Lightroom, and then you'll be able to flick through them with ease, as Lightroom won't have to do too much work to show them, as they are very small previews. Now, the downside to this type of preview is that you can't zoom in on them in the library module. So if you're a pixel peeper or you need to check what exactly your camera focused on, you will have to switch across to the develop module to zoom into 100%. Now, going back to the library module, you'll see that it puts a little logo in the corner of the main preview image and also in the corner of each of these images in the film strip along the bottom. If you click on the logo in the image on the film strip, it will ask you if you want to build a standard size preview for all of the embedded photos or one by one. So this is another way to change the previews if you need to. Now, I really like this type of preview when I'm on a deadline or if I've taken a load of photos, say from a sporting event, and I want to cut through the rough ones really quickly. I'll star rate the ones I like and discard the ones I don't like. So for my photos that weren't that good, Lightroom will never even have to build a preview for them in the first place, and this saves so much time. When you open them up into the develop module, it will take a short while for each image, and this is because Lightroom will have to build a better preview. But then you can zoom in on the image to 100%. If you make any edits to your image, Lightroom will then discard the embedded and sidecar preview and use its own that it built when you did import them into the develop module. But if you don't make any edits, when you switch back to the library module, it will revert back to the embedded and sidecar preview. So in that first stage of cataloging and star rating your images, as long as you don't make any edits in the develop module, it'll keep those embedded and sidecar previews, and this will make the process so much quicker. The standard preview is what Lightroom is set to when you first open the program. It builds the previews at a similar rate with a mechanical hard drive as with minimal previews. But with the SSD, it's a lot slower than minimal previews. So this shows that building the previews takes a lot longer in standard than in minimal. If you go into the catalog settings under the tab File Handling, you'll have everything you need to build the standard previews to the level that you want to. If you set the standard preview size to auto, this will adjust it to the resolution of your monitor. Now, if I'm using my Mac, this is set to 3440 pixels, whereas with my old PC, this was at 1080 pixels, as I had that 1080p monitor. So auto is great if you either switch between monitors or you just want to leave it to your computer to decide. Now, whilst we're on this page, you can see there's also a preview quality and an automatically discard the 1x1 image after X amount of days. This is set to 30 as standard, but you can change it to whatever you want. 1x1 previews do take up a lot of space. So once you've edited your photos, you probably won't go back to them that often, especially after a month or so. So Lightroom deletes the previews to save space. If you do open them up again after the time limit that you've set on this page, Lightroom will once again build a preview, so it will be a little bit slower. But don't worry, it won't delete any of the edits that you've made. It will delete just the previews after the time you have specified here. So this is just a way of managing the size of your catalog and kind of making sure it doesn't get too huge as you load up more and more images into that catalog. Now, one-to-ones are the best quality previews, but do take the longest for Lightroom to build. With a mechanical hard drive, it took 31 seconds for Lightroom to build these 10 images. And with the internal SSD drive, it took 26 seconds. So if you've been on a long shoot and have thousands of images, this type of preview will take the longest. And this will be the time to go and get a cup of tea. Like I've already mentioned, in the catalog setting page, these will be deleted after a certain amount of time to save on your hard drive space. Also, when the computer is building these previews, it does get the fans going, so it is a processor-intensive build. Now, with my machine, I didn't notice much difference in the quality between one-to-one and standard previews once they'd loaded. But this is because the standard preview size in the catalog settings is set to auto. Like I've already said, it will basically make the standard preview to the quality that the monitor is that you're using. And my monitor is 2.5K. Now, this should still mean that the zoom works better with the one-to-one previews, but it really didn't with my computer. And there wasn't any difference with speed either when I was zooming to 100% and back in that library module. Now, if you have seen a difference with these two previews with the system that you're using, let me know in the comments below. It'll be interesting to see if you've found anything different. As for general performance, flicking through the images to star rate them was slow with these one-to-one previews. And this is to be expected as those previews are really big. Once I switched to the develop module, which took a short while to load up again, zooming was a lot smoother. And this has been the case for all previews so far with no noticeable changes in this speed. Smart previews are heavily compressed and they have a surprising amount of quality in them for the level of compression. Lightroom CC uses these to synchronize with Lightroom Mobile and Lightroom Web, and you can turn this on or off in the import window. With standard selected and smart previews checked, with the mechanical hard drive, it took 18 seconds to load these 10 images. With the internal SSD, it took 15 seconds. So it was faster, but not that much faster. Now, nothing really looks that different in the library module. You can zoom in to 100%. Flicking through them is similar to the one-to-one and standard previews, and the only difference I noticed on first glance was the time it took to switch to the develop module. This was almost instant with my system with these smart previews. And then when in the develop module, zooming was a lot smoother. The one great thing with smart previews is that you can edit your photos even if your original files are on a disconnected hard drive. So if you're traveling and your hard drive is in the overhead compartment, or if you've left it at home, you can still edit your images. Whereas with the other previews, you can't. even if you've created one-to-one previews. Unless you have the smart preview checked, there is no way to edit your disconnected images. With all of the other previews, it actually grays out all of the editing tools. As long as you have built smart previews, you can edit your images and you can also export your images as well. However, they will be smaller than the originals. With the original of 6,000 by 4,000 disconnected, I was able to export a 4 megabyte 2,560 by 1,707 sized image. So that gives an indication as to what the resolution is with smart previews and a 2017 MacBook Pro. I'm guessing the resolution would change depending on the size of your monitor. But if you know differently, again, let me know in the comments below. Now, to edit your photos like this, you do need to check a box in the preferences. Under Preferences, Performance, then you check the Use Smart Previews instead of Originals for Image Editing box. Then Lightroom will use these smart previews when you do start editing. However, if you are a pixel peeper and zoom in to 100% a lot, Lightroom will build cached previews at a higher resolution. Now, when editing, I couldn't tell the difference between the smart preview and a 1x1 preview either. So there is definitely some Adobe wizardry going on here. Now, thinking about it, if you do own the A7R series set of cameras with that much higher megapixel, or if you've got a camera that does have a ridiculously high megapixel count, I think that's when you will notice a difference between the smart previews, the 1x1s, the standard, and the minimal. But for something like the A7 III that has around about 24 megapixels, I think, you really won't see that much of a difference. Apparently, if you have a 4K display or higher, you will start to see a difference. But mine is a 2.5K monitor, and I really couldn't tell the difference between these and the 1x1 previews. So if you're using a high resolution monitor, it might be worth giving your computer time to build the 1x1 previews. But it would be worth testing to see if you can get away with the smart previews instead, as it will save you a lot of space on your hard drive. And that's the great thing with all of these different options. Once you understand them, you can really tune it to get it to work the best for you and your system. Now, to select the previews, there are two different ways to do this. When you first import your images, you can select which ones you want on the right-hand side in the File Management menu. This is the only place you can select minimum or embedded and sidecar previews. But just be aware, if you do select one of these, Lightroom will start to build bigger previews as soon as it can. This is basically when you switch to the develop module and make any edits. The second place to access previews is in the library module. In the library drop-down menu, go to previews, and here you can change the ones you have. You can delete or build one-to-one or smart previews and build standard previews. But there's no embedded and sidecar or minimum previews here. So if you do want either of these smaller ones, like I said earlier, you do need to select them in the import window. When you do switch from the library to the develop module, you'll sometimes notice a slight delay, and this will happen with all four of the main preview types. This is because Lightroom is building a cached, high-quality preview that you can edit, zoom in on, and basically make all the changes you need to. So if you are low on hard drive space, this is why you might find that after editing a number of your images, your computer grinds to a halt or puts up that really annoying message saying that you're almost out of hard drive space. Now, it won't do this if you've used Smart Previews and you have selected the Use Smart Previews instead of Originals for Image Editing box checked, and your files are disconnected. Sometimes I find that when I'm star rating my images, I'll switch to the develop module to check them out or to zoom in on them. And then I'll kind of forget to switch back to the library module. And this is when I really do notice a slowdown on my system when flicking through the images. So if you're just browsing to find certain images, or if you're rating images to pick out the best ones, make sure you do switch back to the library module to do this so it doesn't start building cached images for every single image you've taken. To get the fastest possible performance from my system, I always have previews in my input page set to embedded and sidecar. If I need to get a handful of images out really quickly, I'll keep smart previews unchecked. So they'll load really quickly into Lightroom. I'll then stay in the library module and star rate the top 30 images that I like the best. I'll then just select these 30 with a filter and then open the develop module and edit them there. This way, Lightroom will only have to build 30 cached previews to edit, and I can have them ready and exported for the customer, or maybe friends and family if it's a home party or gathering, in a really short amount of time. And it's quite surprising how many images you can get through in such a short amount of time when it's not glitchy when you're going through that film strip along the bottom. Now, if I'm not on a deadline and there's no rush to get them out, I'll still set it to embedded and sidecar on import, but I'll also check the smart preview. In the preferences menu under the performance tab, I'll make sure the use smart previews instead of originals for image editing box is checked. Then I'll go and get a cup of tea and let the computer do its thing and build those smart previews. Once done, I can very quickly rate my images in the library module with no glitchiness or pausing because I've used those embedded and sidecar previews. And then if I want to zoom in to check focus on any one of those images, I'll switch it to the develop module on the few that I want, making sure not to make any edits. So then when I switch back to the library module, it keeps the small embedded and sidecar previews available. Once rated, I'll use the filter to just select those rated images. Then I can edit the photos whether or not the hard drive is connected with no worries. And if I need to export some smaller images for web use or create some previews for the client, again, I don't need to worry if those original files are connected or not. I can export them, I can edit them, and I don't need to worry at all. These two different ways really work for me, and it means I have a way of getting images out fast, and also have the ability to edit my photos even if they're not connected to my laptop. And this is an absolute godsend. There's been quite a few times where I've been on a plane, I've needed to edit photos before getting back to home, and I've been able to edit them without having a hard drive plugged into the side, and it hasn't taken up too much space at all. It really does help, and it just makes things a lot easier. Now, in knowing about these previews, it has saved me a lot of time, and it has saved my laptop from pretty much being thrown out the window on several occasions. Before I knew about these previews, I did find that if I had this setting wrong, it would be really slow when I'm scrubbing through those images on that film strip on the bottom. Or I might be in the wrong module, and again, it slows down loads. And there's nothing worse than being on a deadline and having a computer that's just going so slow. This is when you want to throw that computer out of that window. Now let me know what you use, and also let me know if you're gonna change the way that you build previews after watching this, or if you have an even better way to do it. Let me know in the comments below. I always try and find out what you do, and I'll always try and reply to all of your comments. Well, at least all of the sensible ones, that is. And if you like this video, try one of these two next. Either the one on the left that the algorithm has specifically picked for you, or the one on the right that's one of my playlists to binge watch. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe for 2 weekly videos on photography. I'll see you next time.